we're getting to that point where I've got to set the table. So the dinette booths are in. I've got the shelf overhead already, as you saw in the episode before. And so I thought, you know, I was looking at this Formica or WilsonArt, whichever you're going to buy, and I thought, it's too far gone. It's scratched, it's crinkled, it's ugly to start with. So I'm just going to take this trim off. The trim's in great shape. I'm going to definitely reuse the trim. I'm going to shine it up a little bit with some triple-aught steel wool, and it's going to be just fine. So I took this off, came off great. I'm thinking, wow, good save. Saved some bucks right there. And I thought, I'm going to just scuff this up with a sander. And then I'm going to put the Formica that I bought just right over the top of it. No problem. And then I'll put my frame, my trim back around it. Good to go. Until I took the trim off. Then look what happened. It's not Formica. Not at all. It's Masonite with some sort of pattern on it. Well, big deal, you say. Just go back over this piece because the table is still the same size, right? No. Because if I were to put a very thin Formica over it, and then I would put my trim back on. Woo, it's getting away. All right. Then there's going to be a little lip right here. So every time that you take this down to make your bed, you're going to dent this. You're going to tear up your dinette seat, and then you're going to start tearing this up pretty soon. This is going to come up and come loose. And it's just, it's not, over time, you're not going to be happy with it. I'm not going to be happy with it, and I don't want to send it out of the shop that way. So to fix that problem, I'm going to have to tear up my workbench here because it's exactly the right size. There is just enough room when I set this down right here on this edge. There is just a tiniest little lip that will fit that Formica perfectly. So I'm going to take my workbench or some other piece of lumber I have left over from the camper build, from the walls, and it's going to be the next dinette table, brand new. I found this exact same piece of board, a little cleaner, a little fresher, no warps, be perfect for the table. So I just traced the outline of the old table, and now I'm going to jigsaw it out. Take away the extra. We'll find something to use on that. Look at how nice that is. Start with a good table base, put some good WilsonArt Formica over it, and it's gonna be beautiful. Got the WilsonArt out. I'll show you what it looks like here in a little bit because it's super cool. All right, now I've gotta put some glue right here. This is the approximate area, and we want it to be a little bit bigger because we're going to get the router out. We're going to router around it, but we want it to start drying a little bit. It'll get tacky, and then we'll put it onto the new board table after the glue on it gets tacky. So I'm just going to kind of hit this real quick. And you've really got enough time because it does really want to dry. But if you don't let it dry and get tacky, it'll still work. It just takes a lot longer to dry. But it'll still work. Let me give it a little cross pattern here. And remember, it's also going to have trim on it. It's going to have that trim right there. So that's going to hold everything down. It's not going to be an issue. Now they do make a roll-on adhesive for this. And that stuff, you better not make a mistake with it, because you're not moving it. Once this thing gets set up, that's the end of it. And you better be happy with it. Because that stuff, I've used that several times in the past, and it is pretty sincere. So we're just gonna get this on here nice and good. Let it get tacky. That'll probably, I'll go over here and check this. That's not really tacky yet, but it's starting to get there. So I don't know, maybe it's a little colder out here than normally, but we're well within the range. So it'll probably take maybe another 5 minutes. So we'll let this get tacky, then we're gonna set it up together. All right, I got the glue nice and tacky, and I am getting ready to lay it down on the board. The board is underneath here, the new table, but I've got to pull the sticks out because I put two sticks under here. Oh, shoot. And that is what keeps it from laying down too quick. So I think I've got everything set. Got a little bit of overhang. Now, just kind of lay this here. Let it sit there. Check out this really funky pattern right here. I'm gonna grab something heavy to put on it real quick. Stay right there. So you gotta put something heavy on it. That'll make it really stick in there. He would like you to like and subscribe. You can see that it's making a beautiful edge right here. We're going to turn this corner. I've got to make an adjustment here, and then I'll finish it up, and then we're going to show you what it looks like. I've got the rest of the leg here that I have got to get painted. I kept the leg itself. I made a new trim piece. The other one, I just wasn't satisfied with it. And then there's going to be the part that goes on the back here that attaches to the wall and then comes off. And then that makes it to a bed. But this atomic age, kind of like a bunch of little boomerangs, but they call it like the atomic age WilsonArt. They've got a lot of different colors. This is very interesting. It's got black, green, pink. So it's going to match a lot of things. It's going to be very colorful. And so that's when you got to make a dinette. You might as well make it a pretty dinette. And this one is absolutely going to be gorgeous against all of that white on the interior. So don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll let you know when the next one's coming out. So hit that button, and we'll see you soon.